morning. Today is okay. The date is not important, but I think today is the 1st of November 2018. I chose to talk about the kitchen. Basically, I want to talk to the chefs, the upcoming, the experienced. I have been in this field now. This is my 30th year. I come from Uganda. I have done catering and hotel management certificate. I have done diploma in food production operations. I have done food science and technology. I have been certified as a culinary executive by level 5 by the International Culinary, the American Culinary Federation. I chose to talk about the kitchen because I want to talk about the experiences and the challenges that happen in the kitchen. So what happens is, normally, let's start from the beginning because these are sessions. Now I would talk to a beginner about how to open a kitchen, how to open a kitchen. How do you open a shift when you come on a schedule? When you come on a schedule, the first thing you do when you enter the doors of a kitchen is you switch on the lights of the kitchen. After switching on the lights, you open the ventilation. After opening the ventilation, you check for leakages of gas, because you want to turn your equipment on. So you check your equipment, check if you do not have any leakage, check your gas meter, then turn on the gas. Turn on. It always has a closing pattern. It may be out of the kitchen or in the kitchen, where you close to cut off gas from continuous flow after closure. So when you close, when you open, you have to check your temperatures, the temperatures of the things that you have in the kitchen or in the fridge and the freezers. So check the temperatures. For instance, right now in the country where I am, the chilling temperature should be 1 to 4, at most 5, but you must ensure that your chilling temperature is between 1 to 5. If you are in a country like Uganda or Africa, the temperatures must be 1 to 7. The chiller should not go beyond 7. When the temperatures are above 7, there is high risk for your items to get problems, or they have a higher risk to multiplication of the virus or the amoebas. So then the freezing temperature in the country where I am is 18 degrees, negative 18. Your items must be at negative 18. We can allow it to go fall from 15 to 12. If it is also falling below 12, it is a problem also. So always ensure that your temperatures are correct. Check your items. Check your day tagging. the frozen items always have a day tagging for 1 month, similar to the spices. We always give them a day tag for 1 month, the lifespan. Then the fresh items, we give them, and the chilled items, we give them a date coding for 2 days. So check if all the items have the right day tagging and are proper. Then as you ration to check on your menu, schedule for what you're going to do. For instance, if you're working on breakfast, you need to set up, you need to know what actually you need, which equipment, which items you need to use for your breakfast. It is very, very important, because you don't need to run to work on one thing, then run back to work on another thing. It is very good to make a collective effort, bring your things together, then start working, start planning. When you plan, you know what you need, and it makes your work easy, it makes you more organized. Okay, then also know which thing do I do first. For instance, if you're going to work on breakfast, know that, for instance, I need milk. I will have to have milk, maybe in the boiler, if you're using a boiler, if you're boiling them in a pan, and I don't know at what quantity. But you need to know, what do I put on first? As I work on this, this will be boiling. For instance, you have Irish, you're going to do potato wedges for breakfast. What, or let's say pone panettia. So what do you do? You have to, first of all, maybe if your Irish is already cut and boiled clean, you have to put it in a boiler. Then as you make the other item, the Irish is boiling, because it takes a longer time compared to these other things. If you have, for instance, if you're going to make omelette and you need condiments, how, no, as you work, you always have to multitask to make sure that you meet the goals of time. One other thing that I didn't talk about is the time. The master of the kitchen is not the executive chef. The executive chef is in charge. Your chef de partie, your sous chef, is in charge. But your boss in the kitchen is not the general manager. It is time. So it is very, very important to always value and plan for your time, because your clients are always given time. If you have to serve breakfast or lunch or an a la carte menu, and you're given time, some menus have time frames. So it is important that you maintain the principle of time. So whenever you're working, always plan on your time to make sure that things reach to the guest, or you meet the goals of time. It is very, very important. So today I basically wanted, this clip was to talk about time management and how to open the shift. I will recall back, I told you lights, I told you leakages, then I told you temperatures. Before you go to working, before you go to lighting, you need to know the items you have in the chillers. You need to know if your equipment is proper. You need to have the safety measure to know that your items are in good shape. Okay, so please, this is what I had to share with you today. Thank you for watching and listening to Chef Ronald Binoga. Have a good day. Have a good night. See you on my next episode.